Adventures in Idaho here. I just got this Inland M1 carbine. It's an M1 carbine. I just got it off a gun broker, bought it off a guy, won the auction. So I was going to do an unboxing video here, and we'll take a look at it and see what we got. Okay, we got it all apart. Got the packing taken off, and just looking over it, yeah, it's a 8.43 Inland barrel. That's good. That's correct. This only has a 6-digit serial number, which I knew. I can see right away that the stock, it's an M2 stock. Looking in the sling well right here, I see I-O or O-I, I forget what that is, but that's Inland. And of course it's been through the rebuild after the war. It's got the bayonet lug. The barrel band is SI. The sight is right here. It's RIA. I'll have to look at that. I think that's Rock Island Armory. So that's been replaced. The butt plate, it's got a little rust on it. I can get that off. Throw that in some rust remover. The sight is an H with a shield on it, and we'll take it apart right now. We'll take it apart here real quick and see what the slide, the bolt, the trigger housing, and all that is marked. Let's do that. Got it all taken apart, and one thing I noticed, this is it's an Inland receiver, but it's got an SG right here for Saginaw Gear, and Saginaw Gear provided receivers to Inland up until after this serial number. This is a 6-digit serial number, so that's kind of a rare deal with Saginaw. The barrel is marked Inland 8.43. It's got a proof mark right here. This front sight is a Type 3 front sight, and it's marked RIA, which was used in the rebuilding process for a whole lot of the carbines. So that sight has been replaced. It looks pretty good. The piston, the gas piston works. I had that going here. One thing I noticed, there's a U, a sans serif U right here. I have to look at that a little more. The slide is marked PI in a circle, which is correct for Inland. That's really good. It's got O right here, It's a type 2 slide, which is an early slide, which is good. It should go right with the serial number that this is. This magazine is marked BW right here. It's really in good shape. BW is for Winchester. The recoil plate, the butt plate is shot. It's just totally rusted, but it's a, I looked, quality hardware. It's quality hardware. This is the Bible, of course, as you collectors would know. The Craig Riesch, Volume 8, U.S. Carbines, wartime production. This is where I get all my information. It's kind of like the Bible and stuff. One other thing I wanted to check here was the barrel gauge on the barrel. And if you shove it in there pretty hard, barely gets up to a 2, so that's good. That's good. It's got a good barrel. I looked down the rifling. The rifling is very good, shiny. The stock is a Type 3 stock with the M2 cut out here, and right here it's marked OI. For inland, that's really good. And same thing with a handguard. Right here I got the flaming bomb and the OI right here, so that's inland. Moving on to the trigger housing. The trigger housing is a got a W right here. So it's not an inland. I'm going to take this apart here and look at all the other parts. You know, we can look at the hammer and everything. The bolt is marked right here, N14, which I think is a National Postal Meter bolt. We'll have to take a look at that. We can take this apart real quick and see what the extractor and the firing pin is. The recoil plate is marked right here. It's a Type 3, and it's marked BB, and that's for IBM. So we got an IBM. So we got lots of other parts on it, and that's what I expected, because once it goes through the rebuilding process, or maybe even in the field during the war or something, it needed a new part. They didn't really put the correct parts back on it, but I have lots of parts, so eventually this inland will have a whole lot more parts, at least for the outside, you know, the bolt. I might get a trigger housing for it, we'll see. Let me take the trigger housing and the bolt apart, and we'll look at those parts too. Okay, see, we got the trigger here, got a PDB, I'll have to look that up, the sear is marked SW-S, the dot, the G with a dot, Saginaw gear. The extractor not sure. Got a lot of carbon buildup. I'll have to look at that. Let's look at the firing pin. It's got a mark there, but I can't see it. It's got some carbon. We'll have to look at it. Well, we'll take a look at it and we'll find out what those parts are. Well, my inlet ended up being a pretty nice one, pretty good shape, really, really, really nice shape. Inlet barrel, inlet receiver, inlet stock. Handguard. I did end up with a lot of Saginaw gear parts marked Saginaw gear and some Winchester, but I'll have to take my Saginaw gear I have apart, see if there's any inland parts or any officially marked Saginaw gear parts missing on it. Put them on there. I have a whole bunch of parts. Inlet parts in my parts bin, so I can take the Saginaw gear parts, put them on here, and then take my inlet parts, put them on here. So it's kind of like a swapping deal. That's what all the collectors do, and if you're a collector, you know just what I'm talking about. So that'll do it. I'm gonna get it all taken apart and finish the video when I get it all back together. I always grease all my parts with this, a little bit of grease on all the parts, metal touching metal. That's always a good thing. And when I get it all back together, I'll shoot the last little video deal before I put it on YouTube. Well, Adventures in Idaho here. My inland carbine, M1 carbine that I got off Gunbroker. It ended up to be a pretty nice buy, really. It didn't have all inland parts on it, but that's okay. I've got other carbines I can swap it out with and stuff. But all in all, came out pretty nice, you know?